In this chapter, we'll be discussing about swaps. Swaps are agreements between two parties where each party agrees to exchange future cash flows. It could be like, for example, interest rate payments. So contrary to derivatives, swaps do not derive the value from an underlying asset. And the most basic type of swap is a plain vanilla interest rate swap. If you can understand that, that is more than sufficient. So in this interest rate swap, the parties will be agreeing to exchange interest payments. Say for example, bank A agrees to make payments to bank B based on a fixed rate of interest, whereas bank B agrees to make payments to bank A based on floating interest. So say for example, bank A owns a $10 million investment that pays it LIBOR rate plus 1%. So therefore, as the benchmark LIBOR changes, the payment bank receives also changes. Now assuming bank B has a $10 million investment that pays it 2.5% every month, fixed rate. So it's going to receive fixed interest every month. So now assume that bank A prefers to lock in a constant payment, whereas bank B decides to take a chance on receiving higher payments. It's just that they're taking a different positions on the movement of the interest rates. So one is expecting the interest rate to fall, other is expecting the interest rate to high. So usually swaps will be happening if they take contrary positions. Okay, we don't want the motives of why bank A and bank B wants to do this, but for this example, assume that bank A somehow now wants to prefer a constant payment, whereas bank B wants to prefer a higher payment, so it wants to go for a floating rate of interest. In this case, this bank A and bank B can enter into a interest rate swap agreement. So they simply exchange the payments, and the value of swap is not derived from any underlying asset. So just in this chapter, understand what are swaps and what is an interest rate swap, give an example.